Hello, I'm Miss Su. I work as an English speaking tour guide in Jiangsu province. I will guide them in Suzhou City, and there are three must do in Suzhou City. The first is we must visit the Mustard Nest Garden. So we are here now and enjoying the beautiful sceneries and landscape gardens, signs and inside.
Hey, I'm Stephen, and this is Jess, and we're currently on our second stop of our trip. We just walked through Pyeongjong Street and we had an incredible lunch right here at this restaurant, which actually was kind of delicious, to be honest.
Hey, I'm Jess and this is Stephen, and on our next stop we've just arrived at this traditional ancient town. It is so beautiful seeing an area like this rather than going to the cities and stuff, being able to see something so ancient. It is so cool being able to leave the city and come to a place so unique and full of culture. We just tried embroidery and it's really fun, except it's really hard.
Here on our Wuxi portion of the tourist trip, there's three things that we're gonna do. This is our first stop, and we're at the Lingshan Buddhist Scenic Area. And it's been really exciting so far. First, we gotta go up, and we gotta check out like the sort of temple, huge architecture version of it. And then there's this massive Buddha on top of the mountain. So far, it's been a lot of real fun, and we're really excited to see what's next up on the trip.
So we're currently at our second stop here in Wuxi, and we've just had an absolutely incredible Zen lunch. So before we came to eat our meal, we had a meditation ceremony, followed by washing our hands and then cleansing it with an incense. We then ate our food in complete silence, which was actually really nice, because a lot of times when you're eating, you're on your phone or you're talking to your friends and you're not really focusing on what you're eating. So this was something special because we really got to focus on the food.
Here in Wuxi, in Wuxi Clay Figurine Museum. This is the third place you should visit when you come to Wuxi, because you will get a chance to learn and make your own figurines with the teacher who is the president of this museum and really a master in his job. This clay is almost all its natural reserves are already used, so this might be your last chance to try to do that.
Thank you.
here in Liyang, we arranged this point in our wonderful trip to relax ourselves. We climb the southern mountain here and enjoy a beautiful view of the bamboo forest and experience the spring water here.
We've now arrived at Yangzhou and there are three activities we're doing while we're here. So we spent the morning at Yechuan Tea House. We had the most amazing breakfast. We tried all different types of eggs and dumplings, and something really different is we tried this dumpling and it was full of soup. And what you had to do was pull it to your mouth, open a hole and suck the soup out before you could eat the dumpling. It was really unique but really, really cool.
So we're currently in Yangzhou and there are three things you have to do when you come visit here. And the second thing is to go to Slender West Lake. We just went on a dragon boat and had absolutely beautiful views going along the river. It was just breathtaking. So after our riverboat cruise, we went and experienced a Kunzhen show, and you have to come here to experience it in person. We got to jump on and have a go ourselves. I wasn't very good, but it was so much fun at the same time.
My name is Mia Taylor, and I'm a travel journalist from the United States. One of the three must-do things when you're in Yangzhou is to learn how to cook the Huayan cuisine, which is so interesting and unique to the region. And we had the very exciting experience of learning how to make fried rice here. And it's a fascinating process that takes a lot of muscles to make it. It's a very special fried rice that's famous throughout all of China. Whenever you have this kind of fried rice anywhere, it's from here.
So there are three things to do here in Nanjing, and the first spot is to come to the Nushu Mountain Scenic Area. We've just gone inside Yuznisa and it was absolutely breathtaking. We went 5 stories below the ground to a very religious spot. One of Buddha's artifacts is stored there, so I think it was very spiritual and very interesting to go and visit. I think it was a very good spot to come to.
If you're ever in Nanjing, there's three things to do. Number two is to come to this location, Nanjing Impressions. Absolutely phenomenal food. There's a great variety of salted duck, which is outstanding. The garlic shrimp, and my favorite, the baby IPA. These are made in Nanjing, very tasty. Definitely a must-do Nanjing impression.
Cheers. Cheers.
Here we are at the Nanjing City Wall, which is the third stop on our tour of Nanjing. While we were here, we got to experience bow and arrows and got to see the beautiful Nanjing scenery from on top of the wall itself, which has been here for over 600 years.